Non-Zervian by Rotting Christ is the second studio album by Rotting Christ. They are a black metal band formed in Greece from all countries. They are from there. Yeah, so there we go. Second release, it's 44 minutes long. It's a traditional black metal, anything special. They have a subgenre S, they are Greek, so there we go. Athens, Greece, I suppose. Yeah, doesn't matter. It has overall 9 songs, which were all very solid, I would say. Requested by Capitalism Freedom 69. So there we go. We have the first song, which is The Fifth Illusion. It's a very interesting title, very interesting song in general. Starts off really interesting with that riff at the beginning, and then later going into some slamming, you know, black metal classicness. That is a word. But overall, the song was very, very good in taste, very, a great opener, The Fifth Illusion. It sounds really cool. Arguably my favorite title of the entire record. Cool album cover as well, with the tree in the middle and the ghost going behind it, I guess. Very cool album cover. Rotting Christ even is questionable, but it is black metal, so you cannot have really, soft name, I suppose. So Rotting Christ, I suppose, but it sounds more death metal to me, but doesn't matter. Then we have Wolfera the Chacal featuring Theodoridas F. Statius, aka Anti-Religion. 7 minutes and 13 seconds long. The song is as difficult as the title is, which is a lot. I can leave it at that, but it is just a very complicated song. I did really enjoy it because it just shows very different stuff of the black metal scene, what you can do with black metal. It shows a lot of different things off with Wolfera the charcoal. Sounds very haunting. Charcoals, I believe, not charcoal with an OA, but charcoal. Chacal, which is probably something different. I was thinking about charcoal as in a charcoal for your fire, I suppose, but I have no idea what's going on there. But the song is very interesting. It's probably one of the most diverse and one of the most special songs on the record. So definitely check it out if you want. It is definitely one of the more difficult songs to get into, so if you still want to get into the band, then don't go for that song, but there we go. Then we have Non-Zervian. The title track just is kind of straightforward. It's kind of the most straightforward black metal song of this record. Still very heavy and still very poignant. It still proves out a point or two, and is overall just a very kick-ass tune. It doesn't really have anything else to prove other than that, but to kick ass and to be a good black metal song in general. Then we have Morality of a Dark Age, which is arguably the coolest title again. It just sounds very cool. It just kind of questions your mortality, I guess, morality, whatever that means. When you're living in black metal, I suppose, or the dark age, black metal as in you get stabbed to death, so it's pretty difficult to live there, but if you want to do it, then go for it. It is a very dark and poignant song. It is a very enjoyable piece. If you're really into your darkest days, and this is definitely one of the best songs to put on. It just feels very mellow, very dark, very hollow. Just everything that you feel, every sad, depressing thing that you can think of, this record probably, this record probably has it for sure. Then we have Where Mortals Have No Pride, which is kind of the epic of the album, 7 minutes and 48 seconds. I just love the fuck out of this song. It is just very, very melodic. This was one of the many songs that was just going on and on and on in a good way. As in, you know, I just want to listen to this more and more and more because it is so addictive, it is so catchy, it is so, you know, just fantastic in my opinion. It is just an overall really joyous track with a lot of great fills, a lot of great instrumentation, a lot of great singing as well. Just an incredible piece. Really loved it, arguably the best song of the whole album. And yeah, it's a great song. Then we have Where Mortals Have No Pride, or fuck me, that is just a song that we had. It is just such a great title, I just wanted to say it was. But then we have Phatrioophoria, which is an instrumental which kind of sounds like you're going through the woods or something. Really chill, transitional piece, I suppose. Very chill, very cool. Then we have Mephisis of Black Crystal, which is, again, arguably one of the best titles on there. Just title after title, just fucking incredible. But this song kind of is a shorter version of Where Mortals Have No Pride, kind of a poor man's version, I suppose. But being a poor man's version of like arguably a masterpiece, it's no slouch either. I just really love the title again. Black Crystal just sounds amazing. That is probably a band name at this point, but who knows. But overall this song is just very fantastic. It has a cool title, it has a sweet length. It doesn't drag on, doesn't overstay the welcome. It is original in a way, it sounds haunting, it is kind of creepy as well. It has every black metal element that you want, it has every kind of spooky kind of dark elements that you want. It is just kind of the perfect black metal song. I just really loved it and I wouldn't mind to see more of this really. And then we have Eye Shaped God, which is kind of a earlier black metal song. Again, the title just fucking amazing. The song overall just rocks out. It is an overall incredible piece. Just very in your face, very straightforward track while still having that heaviness, while still having that black metal crunch, I suppose. Just a very fantastic track again. Just overall great, I loved it, and yeah, I can't really say anything else on that. This is just a fantastic, consistent, driving, you know, crystal clear song, I suppose. Eye Shaped God, very powerful title as well, again and again. So yeah, again, incredible piece and amazing. And then we have Saturn Unlock AV Sun, and this was kind of the more mellow, kind of the more closing credit song. Still an incredible song, I suppose. It kind of turns the record on a 180 because the record kind of goes more into an experimental and a more mellow part, like I said. Definitely one of the best closing songs for sure. The only fucking hell. Definitely this closing song is still one of the best, I suppose. But definitely the songs that came before it are no slouches either. It's really difficult to have a favorite of a record full of classics on there. So Saturn is definitely a classic release. It just feels very ancient, very, you know, ancient in a good way, very thought-provoking, very wise, very historical in a way. This is kind of a song like that. Kind of is a history song while not being boring. So that is probably my opinion on the song. It is very long as well. It's kind of the epic of the record together with Where Mortals Have No Pride. And it's kind of the credit song, so you have all of those things combined into Saturn and you have a great closing piece which kind of, you know, tells a history lesson on you while still kicking your ass. So It has all of those things going for it. Really lovely closing song, and arguably one of the best songs of this record, and arguably of their whole career. But I still have to check more out by them to really determine that, but definitely a high point in their career. So overall, great great album by a great band. I've checked out their discography, and they're pretty much a flawless black metal band, so I will definitely listen to more of them, because this was a fantastic album in my opinion. There were some moments where I was like, eh, with the instrumental was kind of eh to me, and well, besides that, really. Yeah, and I think that Will Ferrell, the Shekel, was kind of iffy to me. Those are really the only two flaws of the record. Besides that, it is pretty much a flawless piece. So I will give this record a 9.4. Really great record. Let me know if you guys want me to check out more like this. Let me know in the comments down below. I've been Ondas. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel Ondas for videos like this one. Let me know what you thought about this record. And peace.